Hello and welcome to KivyTips. The new series is going to be about some useful stuff I learned while playing with Kivy framework. This video is about reporting. Reporting, no matter if it's going to be on GitHub or on StackOverflow, for example. So, what's important for reporting? Well, first of all, having a problem. Then we need a way to reproduce the problem, which is one of the most important reporting parts. You might have a problem and paste the whole code base you work with, but no one will read it, not even you. It's A. time consuming, B. not readable at all if you have a huge code base, and C. it contains lines completely unrelated to the original problem. And there is the last part of reporting, description. Well, what if we can partially skip that single part and during the way either solve our problem or make the code so obvious it'll tell almost everything about the problem? Well, we can't get rid of the description completely though, so don't just paste the code on reporting. Let's look at the concept of minimal, complete and verifiable example, as this thing is quite commonly mentioned in the comments on Stack Overflow when a new question is, well, a candidate for garbage. Minimal. I believe you've already seen at least a single GitHub issue or Stack Overflow question with code longer than 500 lines. The worst of them have even imports of an unrelated subject, for example a report about some GUI problem imports some random library. If the question is attempting to get to the download hell, it contains even imports of some custom modules the example won't run without. Nice job. Minimal means that it should contain only code related to the problem and nothing more. Complete. This part is chained to the verifiable part, so I'll describe both. It basically means this. Unless our code encapsulates the whole problem, it can't really reproduce it in the same shape, therefore a potential solution most likely won't help us. So, let's get to it. There are five basic templates. It will help us to at least avoid the download hell and will surely increase the response time from what the hell to something more helpful like, hey, have you tried this or that? For problems related to Kivy language or layouts only, it's really useful to reproduce it with the Kivy language in the smallest possible way. There is a function in builder class called loadString, which obviously loads the Kivy language string. If there's a root widget, that's the only thing with no spaces or tabs if you fancy them, and with no pointy or angle brackets after the language directives. Such a line mostly means this is a root widget and its instance is returned from the loadString function. The other really useful function is runTouchUp. That's just a core function that simply said displays any Kivy widget in a window. Let's look at the basic example of two buttons with some language directives. A similar method, now for a widget, made in Python, can be applied too. Just put an instance of Python class into the runTouchApp function. For example, custom label with string property in it. Now, imagine we want a full screen window, or a window that has some properties changed. Or perhaps there is something we want to change through the config. Well, instead of dropping your whole application code to the report, it can be much simpler. Let's see a five line example of a window without any decorations. Just a note, such a window can be closed with an escape key. What if there is a module in Kiwi that can be run even without using a window? We obviously don't want to paste the whole beast. What about playing a sound? Now remains only a short, complex example of an application. So let's do one that contains a Q language string, custom widget, and a keyboard listener. this is pretty much it. If you keep your code simple and give it the same description, most of the reports should be solved quite fast. Thanks for watching and happy coding!